I was an undergraduate student studying computer science, and I was watching Black Mirror series, which is a sci-fi series that explores the dark side of technology and artificial intelligence, or AI. I remember that I was very fascinated by those scary robots that are equally intelligent as human, taking over the world, the one that they cause lots of job displacement, control human brain and the daily actions, and even the one that they will use as AI military weapons, that they can change the shape of the war in the future. So I was so excited about the potential of AI that can change the world. At that night, I decided that I wanted to be a part of this. So I studied a Master of Science in AI, and then after I graduated, I applied for a PhD project that would allow me to work closely with industry. But at that point, I couldn't find a project that was completely relevant to my interest. But one of the things that I could find was the application of AI for cancer treatment and healthcare problems. I was a bit disappointed. Medical application for AI? But you know, I needed a PhD and I knew that, so I decided to focus on learning more about AI in my PhD, like computer vision, deep learning, machine learning stuff. And after I graduate, I would apply for jobs at big tech companies like Google. And once I was there, I would be able to find the right team that can help me to make my dreams a reality and be part of that robotic future. So I started my PhD. My PhD project was the prediction of radiotherapy for patients with pelvic cancer. You know, there are some side effects for most of the patients with radiotherapy that they experience after the treatment, and these side effects can impact the quality of life. You know why this happens? Because this radiotherapy beam not only kills the tumor, but it also can affect the healthy organs around the tumor, and it can damage the healthy organs around it. So patient has no cancer, but it has to deal with side effects. For example, a patient with pelvic radiotherapy may experience long-term diarrhea for the rest of their life. Imagine, there's no cancer, but the patient has to cope with diarrhea. So, how AI can help this problem? AI can analyze patient data like CT scan, dose treatment plan, clinical data of patient, and then predict the side effects, the diarrhea, for the patient. And this information of prediction can give the doctor about if information about how each treatment plan has risks and side effects. So the doctor can make a better decision for treatment, and hopefully patient can receive a better treatment and experience fewer side effects. So I know about my project, I know how AI is going to solve it. Now it was my time to go to hospital to receive my data set and know more about the radiotherapy treatment. I went to hospital a couple of times, and I saw many incredible people, including children, bravely fighting against cancer. And I saw how they were suffering from the cancer and the treatment. I came home and I read more and more about cancer, and I saw sadly how many people lose their loved ones to cancer every day. UK statistics revealed that every 2 minutes in the UK, one person is diagnosed with cancer. Then it was the time that I realized the severity of the problem. And the only thing that I could think of was, how can I help? So I started to search how AI can impact the healthcare problem, and I found that AI has been already used to improve many healthcare problems apart from cancer. For example, there are many studies that focus on early detection and diagnosis of diseases, like predicting the risk of a heart attack by analyzing the retina of a patient. Or even more important, AI can help for drug discovery. We all know that from COVID-19 that the process of developing a new vaccine can be very time consuming. AI can help to make this process faster. It can basically simulate the behavior of a drug in a patient body and then help the doctor to create that medicine or drug that is more likely to be effective for that disease. Or moreover, AI can help with new devices and technology for monitoring people outside of this traditional healthcare system. Imagine that we will have an app on our phone that can analyze our data and then scan our fingerprints, get our heart rate, and then predict or give us information about our health situation. I found it incredible, and I decided that I wanted to be part of this. I realized that AI has the potential to make differences on people's life. So I wanted to be a part of this. I started to do my research with all my heart. I conducted lots of research. I participated in many conferences, and I finished my PhD. I published a couple of journal papers that they have the results of my research, which is a deep learning system that can analyze patient data and predict the side effects and even detect the anatomical regions in the body that they are associated with the side effects and even detect the clinical risk factors for each patient that may develop these side effects. As I remember, I always wanted to work at big tech companies. I thought this would be the best way to make a change in the world. But my PhD made me realize that helping other people is more important than anything else for me in the world. I don't want to go to industry anymore. Instead, I'm staying in academia. I'm a postdoc now doing research again for AI on medical application and cancer treatment. Now I'm very excited about what AI could bring us about in the future. I believe that it has the potential to help to solve some of the world's most pressing problems like cancer, poverty, and even climate change. I'm even more excited about how AI can improve our life in many ways, like education, finance, communication, and research even. Of course, there are some risks that they are associated with AI, and we need to be careful how to use it or how to develop it so it doesn't end up harming people. But I believe that the potential, the benefit potentials of AI outweigh its risks. Now, when people talk about those scary robots taking over the world, I imagine something different. I see robots helping doctors performing surgery remotely for deprived area, or creating that intelligent organ for people who have lost their ones, and even the AI technology devices that let the blind people see the beauty of our world. Thank you.